y'all, Bridget Bartlett here with My Vision Agency, and today I want to show you how you can create custom fields to help you organize all of your members inside of your SaaS platform. Now, you'll see here inside of this particular profile, I have these different groups that I've created custom fields for, and if I click in the MVA plan, you'll see that I can tell what plan this user is on. I can tell if the plan is active or canceled, the subscription status, the date that the next payment is due, the date the last payment was received, the payment status, and even the date that the plan started. Now, the reason I actually created this for my own business and I wanted to share this with you is because a lot of times if someone contacts you here and they say, hey, my account is paused, and you go to troubleshoot that and see why is the account paused. Before I created this, I was going over to the notes section because I do obsessively create notes in my profiles. I also have to go over here to the payment section and see when was that last payment made. Sometimes I have to go through the workflows to figure out what happened. Was it a failed payment? Did they cancel at one point? And so these fields really streamline my entire communications so that I don't have to do all of that digging around. I can immediately tell in this example that Jane Doe is on a free starter plan, which tells me that she signed up because she used my affiliate link for high level. And so that immediately tells me that now I need to go down to the high level affiliate section and I need to check the status of the high level account if Jane Doe is telling me, hey, my account is paused. I can see the status of the high level account. I can tell when she became a lead, a trial, when the last commission was generated, the date that she started her high level account, if the account was canceled, what was the date, and I can even tell what was the last commission that was earned. Now, all of this is created by using custom fields and updating the custom field when these actions take place. Before we dive into today's training, I wanted to invite you to go to myvisionagency.com. There you can create a high-level free trial. You can sign up for our reseller program if you're a current high-level customer, and you can also join our free community where you will get access to open office hours 4 days a week. You can watch today's training and then also join us for the Q&A session that we have with all of our community members. Now, let's get started. There are three steps that are required for this automation. Step one, you need to create the custom field that you want to update. Step two, you need to create the workflow to update the custom field. And then step three, you need to create the workflow to trigger for the update. Now, that might seem super confusing, so I definitely want to go through. I'm going to show you my workflows that I have, and then I want to show you from scratch how you can create these for yourself. Now, if we go inside of my account here, you'll see if I go to reseller subscriptions, I have these automations for the different plans that we have. I also have a trigger to reactivate resellers and subscription issues, reminders. And then you'll see this one here, reseller plan status has changed to active. So when I change that custom field from canceled or if it's empty and then it gets changed to active, it triggers these automations to take place. So you'll see here, the custom field has been updated and the plan status has changed to active. When that happens, we're updating the custom field and all of the tools that we have in our program. I'm adding tags, I'm updating the opportunity, granting reseller access to the community, the courses. I'm creating all of these additional tools. And I'm also determining here, are they a new member starting their plan today? Or have they reactivated their plan? So this workflow is going to trigger as soon as that custom field gets changed over to active. So if I manually come in here and I go to plan status and I change this from nothing to active, it's going to trigger this workflow to take place. Now, I also need to make sure to have a step in my workflows that will update this to active when they have purchased the plan. So I'm going to go back here and you'll see the MVA starter plan, for example. I have all of my triggers here and I have a step here for the if-else conditional logic. I want to determine is the payment successful, failed, or order submitted. And you can see in this example, payment is successful, and I'm updating the payment status to successful. So you can see all of these fields are being updated. And then you could even add a math operation and then add 30 days, for example, to a specific field to create a new date. There's so many things that you can do with custom fields. But the main process here is we want to create that custom field. We want to update the custom field in our workflow. And then we want to create another workflow that is going to take place when that field has been updated. So let's go into this demo account here and let's actually create that. So we're going to go to settings and we're going to scroll down to custom fields. Let's create a folder. So I'm going to go here and add folder. We're going to call this plans and save. And let's click into the plans folder we created. And now let's create our custom fields. So we want to choose what type of custom field do we want to use. In the example I was using before here, you can see that I actually have a drop down field here. So I can choose active or canceled. So if I wanted to choose that here, I would choose drop down single because the answer is going to be one answer. So I'm going to choose that and next, and I'm going to create this for the plan status. We're going to keep it in the plans group, and now I'm going to choose active or canceled. Now I can also choose suspended if I have a step for that, but in this example, we'll just do active or canceled. And let's go ahead and save. All right, so now that we have this custom field that we want to update and we have our folder here, we need to create the two automations for active and cancel. So let's go back into our automations and I'm going to click here to create a new workflow and I'm going to click here to choose subscription. I'm going to add filters, choose status is active. The important thing that you want to determine here is what is it that you need to create that you want to update that field. So is it when they purchase a product? Is it when they start a subscription? Is it when they make a payment? Those are the things that you need to determine in this workflow. So most of you already have a workflow where someone signs up and they purchase something and then you have all of this onboarding in your workflow that takes place. So don't focus so much on the trigger here because really in this part, this is just going to be whenever someone makes a purchase. So I'm going to add this up here, start a new plan. So we'll say anytime that status is active, save the trigger. So let's just pretend that this is our trigger here of when someone starts a new plan. This is the important part here. We want to update that contact field. So I'm going to click here and let's choose the field that we created. We have plan status, active. So in this example, we have a subscription that has been moved to active. And then now we want to update this plan status to active. And let's go ahead and save. Now, what we need to do is create a workflow that takes place when this field has been updated to active. So let's go back now and create a new workflow. And let's say when the plan status has been updated to active. And we're going to choose that trigger. And it's going to be contact changed, add a filter. We're going to choose that field and we're going to say hash change to active and save. Now here we can put whatever steps in our workflow that we want to add when that plan status has been updated to active. I showed you my example. You may have a completely different workflow, but that's okay. This is the important part here that we need to make sure that we create. So I'm just going to go ahead and save this. And of course you would want to publish this to make sure that it is active. And those are the steps that we need to create for the active portion. Now, if we go back and check our guide here, We have created the custom field. We have created the workflow to update the custom field. And we've created the workflow to trigger for the update. But we've only done that for the active section. Now we need to do this for the cancel. We don't need to create the custom field because we've already created that. We just need to create a workflow to update the custom field to canceled. And then we also need to create that workflow that happens when it's been updated to canceled. So let's go back into our automations and create a new workflow. We're going to start from scratch. And let's say this one is subscription canceled. So we're going to choose subscription as our trigger again. We're going to choose the status is canceled and save. Let's give this a name. And of course, you may have many different steps in here that you want to add when a subscription is canceled. I just want to focus on the important steps in this particular workflow. So we're going to click here, and the important part here is to update that contact field. So we're going to choose update field. Let's search for our field that we created for plan status. And then we're going to change this to canceled and save action. We're going to go ahead and save. And of course, we want to publish. Now we need one more workflow. So I'm going to go back here now. Let's create the last workflow here. And let's go ahead and give it a name. We're going to name this workflow plan status field changed to canceled. Now the trigger here is going to be contact changed. We're going to choose our field, has changed to cancel. Now, whatever actions we want to take place when a subscription has been canceled, we can just start building out that workflow here. Now, what's cool about this setup is that you can build in this update of the custom field in your workflows. So if you have your subscription canceled and you have a bunch of things that you want to add, you can just simply choose update the status to canceled, and then it will trigger these automations to take place. Now, the reason that I didn't just add this to a workflow of canceled is because I want to be able to go back to the contact and I want to be able to manually change this. So for me to be able to manually change this in the profile and trigger those workflows, I have to have that additional workflow that will trigger when this status has been changed. So if I change this manually because I realize, oh, Jane Doe, her account should be active, and I change this to active, I want it to go through that workflow, and then I want it to update everything that an active subscription has. But if I didn't build that workflow that triggers when this has been updated, then I would not have that ability to trigger workflows here from the profile. Now, if you have any questions at all, feel free to go to myvisionagency.com. You can click here to join our free community and access open office hours that begin as soon as this training is over. Monday through Thursday, we have a live training session followed by open office hours. If you are interested in signing up for high level, you can choose this option here and get a free membership in our reseller program. If you're a current high level customer, you can sign up here for just $97 a month. Thank you all so much for joining me, and I look forward to working with you in open office hours. Go make your vision a reality. Bye.